Pioneer viewers, we continue to bring you the Russia-Ukraine war. As you all know, the war continues and the developments in recent days have led to an emergence of the different views on the war process. The Russian-Ukrainian war has an important place on the agenda of international politics. The war, which directly and indirectly affects the European continent, have caused European countries to take some drastic steps in terms of security. European countries have increased their defense expenditures due to the security concerns and are sending support packages to Ukraine to fight against the Russian invasion. Political developments and military developments directly affect the war processes, and one of the most critical issues in the times of the war is to gain international support. It is not possible for the states to bear the burden of the war alone in the real economic order where the resources are limited. Therefore, cooperation and alliance relations must be established. More than 2 years have passed since Russia launched a full-scale invasion of Ukraine, and during this time, the sides have confronted each other many times on the front lines. There have been mutual casualties, and the fighting is still ongoing. But one of the most important issues in all it has been the involvement of other countries in the war. In the ongoing war between Russia and Ukraine, European states and the US have refrained from intervening directly. The allegations that have emerged in recent days have caused a great controversy. In the audio recordings served by the Russian press, it was determined that the German generals were talking about hitting Russian targets. Following these allegations, Russia began to experience days full of anxiety. And according to the information obtained, intensive work is being carried out in Russian military units. The work in the military units started immediately. After the audio recordings were published, the transportation problem of the Russian army is known by everyone, and the Russian officials are very concerned because it will take even more time to reach the costly land like Crimea. Now, if you're ready, let's examine the developments together. As the Pioneer, we continue to report on Russia-Ukraine war. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications so that you don't miss our daily map reports and reports on the agenda. I also read all your comments on our videos. Please continue to share your ideas about our content in the comments with us. Let's start if you are ready, the Pioneer reports. The audio recordings that emerged in the past days were served by the Russian press, and the incredible recording included a private conversation between German generals, and the possibility of the possible attack on the Russian targets is not a desirable situation for Russia, which is struggling in the war against Ukraine. Russian officials are trying to hide their fears while expressing their reactions on the issue. But Russia has no chance against a possible intervention by another state. It is known that European countries have been holding talks about the intervention operation against Russia in recent days. The Ukrainian army's attacks against Russian targets continue, and later in the night, drones of the Ukrainian army attempted a significant attack on the Russian targets. The operation organized by the Ukrainian army with unmanned aerial vehicles created a great panic in Moscow. Following the Ukrainian attacks, Russian authorities closed the Kerch Bridge in Crimea to traffic. And a statement was made by the Russian Defense Ministry. According to the statement, Crimea was targeted in the attack launched by the Ukrainian army with 38 drones. Moscow authorities did not make any statements about the casualties of the Ukrainian attack. Local sources reported explosions near Feodosia, about 100 kilometers from the Kerch Bridge. The Kerch Bridge is a key strategic link between Russia's Krasnodar region and the Crimean Peninsula, which Moscow has controlled since annexing Crimea from Ukraine in 2014. Ukraine has repeatedly targeted the bridge in more than 2 years of full-out war, using long-range missiles supplied by West to attack key supply routes for the Russian troops. Previous attacks by the Ukrainian army have repeatedly closed the bridge, proving that the vulnerability of the Russian logistics are high. And the Ukrainian military's strategy is slowly starting to show its results. The Ukrainian army has been carrying out a long-term plan to reduce Russian influence in the region. First of all, they established a psychological superiority over the Russian soldiers in the region. In the phone records of the Russian soldiers, it was determined that the possibility of an attack on Crimea at any moment had upset the psychology of the soldiers. Another goal of the Kiev authorities was to reduce the influence of the Russian Navy in the Black Sea. The grain corridor in the region needed to function safely. The Russian Navy's aggressive actions and insecure stance in the region led Ukraine to work on this issue. Ukrainian drones targeted important parts of the Russian Navy. After the targeted ships were shut down and destroyed, the Russian army withdrew the Navy to more backward areas. The withdrawal of the Russian Navy from the Black Sea was an important achievement for the Ukrainian army. Ukraine, which carries out its activities in the region more comfortably, has become an important power in the Black Sea. The ongoing operations of the Ukrainian army were effective throughout the war, and the contributions of the Ukrainian military intelligence in this regard were very important. The Ukrainian army's posture and planned actions in both counterattacks and defense positions are in the main factors in success. Recently, footage of the attack organized by the Ukrainian army against Russian targets has emerged. In the footage, it was determined that the kamikaze drones of the Ukrainian army neutralized a Russian combat vehicle traveling in the convoy. It is estimated that the Ukrainian military intelligence obtained information about the route of the Russian convoy, and the Ukrainian military intelligence is continuously following the movement of the Russian army, sometimes through information leaked and sometimes through early warning systems. All information about the Russian troops and the Ukrainian territory reaches the hands of the intelligence. After the footage of the Ukrainian attack was posted on social media, thousands of people watched it in a short time. We can say that the Russian-Ukrainian war has already gone down in history, and in the war, which pioneered a radical change in the methods of the warfare, the use of unmanned aerial vehicles came to the forefront. We observe that the Ukrainian Army's Air Force is performing almost all of its missions with the unmanned aerial vehicles, and this shows that all the known methods of the warfare will change in the future years. So, what do you think about Russia's concerns in Crimea? Do you think it is getting harder for Russia to hold on the Crimea because of rising costs and transportation problems? What do you think about the Ukrainian Army's attacks on the Russian convoy? How do you think that the Moscow authorities view the possibility of any European state getting involved in the war? Do you think the use of drones by the Ukraine and Russia could be a precursor to change in the methods of the warfare? I do read your comments and I care about them. Please share them with me.